I think when you get a play on in the West End, it's important, and I think when a play does well, it's a lot of hard work behind it. So I think to get to the stage where you can put a production on, get an audience in, get a great cast together, it feels special because it's known as such an art centre. So that's a very special thing and should be acknowledged, especially the fact that the city is almost unlivable now due to house prices. So the fact that people can come out and watch a show and the actors are making a living from it is very special. So the arts are very important to London and sometimes forgotten. It's about people being, or not all of them, but the kind of pretentious capitalist approach by some of the characters versus the, you know, the smaller person, the someone with a conscience is the kind of forgotten person society today. So it's actually quite a relevant topic. I think, you know, the bold and the brash might be seemingly succeeding, but actually the person you care for in that play is the is Simon Bird's character, which is the most genuine person. And that's Last Man. I mean, that's just been Last. I'm filming the A Word at the moment for BBC One until the end of July, and then that should hopefully come out in the autumn schedule, BBC. So BBC One, second series of the A Word at the moment. The diagnosis of Joe has happened, and now it's kind of the ripples a year and a half to 2 years on as to what's happened for the rest of the family and to Joe himself, how everyone's coping with life. And Peter Bowker, the writer, has written some really fantastic twists and turns in the whole storylines that hopefully the audience will enjoy. I get people stopping me saying, oh my goodness, the A Word, I really enjoyed that, and what about the young boy Max? That's all I get. So I get stopped so I can pass on a compliment to Max, who plays Joe, which is totally justified and correct.